I'm your biggest fan. I'll follow you until you love me, Papa.
I'm your biggest fan.
Management techniques from Five Alarm Fire. Started.
This firefighter made a stunning catch, saving a little girl just in the nick of time.
Here's a 911 call I actually responded to as a former firefighter paramedic. It's about 3 o'clock in the afternoon, and we get dispatched to a BLS yellow general illness call. Those types of calls are generally not an emergency and are not urgent. I knock on the front door, and a man who appears to be in his 70s calmly answers the door wearing sweatpants and a t-shirt and slippers. So I looked at him and said, "How can I help you today?" He looks back at me with a smile on his face and says, "My wife isn't feeling too well." Meanwhile, my partner, who is a brand new EMT, is gathering gear from the ambulance. Now, the man's body language is not suggesting that there's much of a problem. So I calmly follow him into the living room. And what do I find in the living room? His wife, laying on the floor naked like a starfish. I quickly realize that she is in cardiac arrest. So I radio for my partner to come in and help me with CPR. My partner has never done CPR on a live person before. I quickly start doing CPR, and I look up and see my partner running through the front door going 1,000 miles an hour. He trips over the hallway rug and lands nose first right in her crotch.
Wholesome story time. So one day I left for work about 15 minutes after my boyfriend did, and when I got out I realized traffic was unusually bad. So I called him to pass the time, and he was panicking. He said he was the cause of traffic because a kitten had jumped into his engine in the middle of the road. All the cars stopped to let this kitten pass, and she decided that she wanted to find a home in his wheel well. So he was scared to move the car, so he was blocking traffic. Eventually, firefighters came, helped us move his car into the Burger King parking lot, and then we squirted the kitten out with water after about an hour of trying to dig her out. Clearly, she was very unhappy. She was really, really young. So we took her home, got her nice and dry, took care of her for the night. And then the firefighter, who initially came on scene saying that he was a dog man, took her home, named her Subaru, and this is her now.
Who can say where the road goes, where the day flows? Only
shake that body, say the water, water, grill. Get crunk with it, why get loose with it, why? Like y'all said, let Bruce do.
It's gonna take an hour and a half.
That's it.
My mama and my daddy was fighting last night. Yeah, she kicked my daddy out.
What'd she kick him out for?
'Cause he was cheating on her with my auntie. Yeah. I like your hair.
Thank you.
That's a wig. My mama be wearing those.
I like your shirt.
Thank you. My mama stole it from Walmart. She be boosting. Our lights just got cut off. My daddy got STDs.
Wait a minute.
Here's another 911 call I actually went on from a former firefighter paramedic. We got dispatched to that house. Yes, that one. The one that has called over 100 times this year. But I digress. This particular residence has two residents in it that weigh over 500 pounds. They call all the time for every little tiny possible thing they might need, as if I was their butler. But today, the female is complaining of severe chest pain, because she knows when she says chest pain, we come running quickly. Now, this house stinks very much bad, very, 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 very much bad, all the time, but today it's even worse. I walk in, and I'm polite like always, and I say, how can I help you today?
She says, oh, my chest right here, it's really hurting bad.
Now, when she says chest, she means large breast, like they weigh 50 pounds apiece breasts. During the physical exam, I found a sandwich under her breast. Oh, it was rotten and smelled horrible. Horrible. Oh, my God, it was horrible.
First thing a girl did was a bop on the whole damn cake and the cherry on top. Shook up the bottle, made a good girl pop. You ain't even here to party. Ken in the club tryna pipe a Barbie. I don't wanna go, go, go with the flow back then till I touch my toes. I don't wanna roll, roll, roll the boat.
I've always liked to play with fire.
Oh my gosh.
What do I do?
Damn, your girl so fine, but her breath is like. She says she wanna dance, but she don't know how to. I'm iced out, ooh, looking like a star. Her name is Jenny, ooh, bitch don't have no panties. I'm Steph Curry, when I hit the three, I hit the.
You know, waiting for a good day to happen, you know. Waiting around, the ups and downs, you know. I just said, look.
Today I'm going to show you guys our detox sauna. So I just had a structure fire, was exposed to some smoke from an attic fire. First thing we're going to do is strip down, get into the shower. Going to go down after the shower and turn on our detox sauna. It's Sauna Ray. It's a 4-person sauna, but we only have 2 bikes in there now. Here's our towel to start with. It gets up to about 112 degrees is what we normally keep it at, and we ride for about 10 minutes. Try to sweat all that stuff out of our pores. Keep wiping off with the towel. Get all that nasty stuff off of our skin. As you can see the towel now, I mean, that's just being in the smoke for just a little bit. Jump back in the shower and get ready for the next call.
So as some of y'all may know, I'm a fireman and I'm normally on call every night. I guess I got home last night and I freaking took my pants off and my boots off the same way I have my bunker gear at the fire department.
Special Fields working defensive mode, and we'll just work on rehabbing our folks. Be advised, all units on the southeast incident, we're going to be Rehab is set up. Squad 115 is handling, and it is in front of O'Reilly Auto Parts. Rehab Medical is in front of O'Reilly Auto Parts.